So I'm doing this Kia Rondo. This is a 2008. If you remember, I was diagnosed in this car for a faulty ABS pump, which we did replace, sitting right there. Today I only wanted to do a few things here. We did the valve cover job, spark plugs. Replaced the serpentine belt, which was an absolute nightmare, partly because I guess I wasn't thinking through. So anyway, I just want to show you a trick if you're gonna do it. It's a 17 millimeter for the tensioner. What you want to do is put the 17 millimeter on the tensioner from underneath the car. Let me see if I can show it to you from underneath the car. So we're gonna go right there. All right. It's hard to see, but this first pulley right there, second pulley. The second pulley, that's the tensioner. So you're gonna try to fit this, a very tight space. If you have a serpentine belt tool, that's better. If not, the 17 millimeter. What I ended up doing is put just a regular, because I had the ratcheting wrench, the long one, but it wasn't giving me enough swing to do what I needed to do. So I did a 17 mil, and I used another one for more leverage on top of that, like a 19 mil, and I pulled it right from here. I pulled all the way to the end here, and I took a bungee cord and I tied the bungee cord around the second wrench and tied it around here. You see that? That's it. So once I did that, I definitely had enough slack to do what I had to do. But before I got to that point, it literally took me half an hour to just go up and down and up and down and trying to route it. It was just hell, really. Yeah. So anyway, I'm also doing replacing the control arm ball joints, and this would be, if you're gonna do this job, the easiest ball joint job you ever do in your life. Smart enough they are on this car, the ball joint is actually held on by bolts. Can you imagine that? How sweet. Not like the Toyotas, because the Toyota you still have to kind of pry it down. This one you don't have to. That's the control arm, basically. It doesn't come with that. That's the ball joint. Look at that. You don't even have to do it. No prying action, nothing like that. Just take these two bolts right there, one and two. Take the one over there, take the one over there, boom. I mean, you know, ridiculously easy, man. I wish all manufacturers would just copy this style of ball joint. It would really make things a lot easier for mechanics and DIY guys there. So I'm about to get on this side and do the same thing. I think after that, I was trying to do the bushings on the sway bar, but it requires that you drop the subframe a little bit, at least, you know, partly drop the subframe to get to the bolt that's at the back. There's no space there to get anything in there. So I am not getting paid for that kind of a job. I thought it would be something that I could access easily without having to dismantle the entire subframe. It's not the case. So I'm definitely gonna just return those to the owner, be like, okay, well, this requires a frame job and I didn't coach you for that. And that's that. Yeah, so just a quick tip, you know, if you're ever doing this job, don't fear. I mean, it's really, really, really one of the easiest ball joints I've ever done in my life. All right, YouTube, I'll catch you on the next video. You have yourself a good night.